I've talked before about the Jussie Smollett case and the Jussie Smollett verdict. But what I haven't talked about is the responsibility and the abrogation of duty and the shenanigans that have been pulled by Kim Foxx, who was the Cook County state attorney, the supposed prosecutor of Jussie Smollett. The good thing is that there's now a report by Dan Webb. Dan Webb is the special prosecutor who was appointed. This is the guy who prosecuted Smollett. But what he does is he goes back and he looks not just at the Smollett case, but he's done a report on the behavior of the office of Kim Foxx, and he finds all kinds of improprieties. Let's refresh your memory. When Smollett was first busted by the cops, and they had the goods on him, they had all the evidence that was eventually presented in the trial, but nevertheless, Kim Foxx's office, A, dismissed the 16-count felony indictment. In fact, had no requirement that Smollett either plead guilty or accept any responsibility. They really gave Smollett no real punishment. They just gave him essentially 15 hours. I had over 1,000 hours, by the way, of community service. 15 hours of community service. And then they said, listen, you've paid a $10,000 bond. You're going to forfeit that. So Jussie Smollett was going to get off scot-free. Now, Dan Webb looks into the behavior of Kim Foxx, and he finds all kinds of violations. First of all, Kim Foxx from the beginning was conspiring with a couple of other leftists, a woman named Christina Chen. By the way, this is Michelle Obama's former chief of staff, and a woman named Sherilyn Ifill, who's president and director counsel of the NAACP Legal Defense Fund. So this is how the left works in concert in order, in this case, they knew that Jussie Smollett was guilty, but their idea was he's promoting our narrative. You know, racism everywhere, even if he had to make it up. So they're like, how do we get this guy off? So Kim Foxx, for example, had said publicly, and you really see the level of public deceit, because she publicly said that I've recused myself from the case. She said, you know, I did contact Smollett's sister. I was in contact with the family when I thought he was a victim. But once I realized he was a suspect, that we were looking into him as the possible perpetrator, I had no contact whatsoever with the family. And Dan Webb basically says this is a flat out lie. He points out that on multiple occasions, I think he identifies at least three, that Kim Foxx continued to maintain contact with Jussie Smollett's sister. And this, he says, was an abuse of power. Now, Dan Webb does conclude in this report. He says, look, I'm not saying that Kim Foxx should be prosecuted, but I do think that she's guilty of ethical violations. And I think that's enough to say, listen, this is a woman who should resign. This is a woman who should be pushed out, because she has been found on multiple counts, by the way, here, unethical conduct. So she sent 5 text messages, talked on the phone on 3 separate occasions. And this is 5 days after she insisted publicly that she had cut off communication with the family. Number two, the office of Kim Foxx said to the media and to the public, we're giving Jussie Smollett the same treatment as we would give any other defendant. He's meeting the same criteria. There are some 5,000 similar cases. And Dan Webb goes, quote, there were not thousands of similar cases. In fact, he says that the office of Kim Foxx, quote, did not identify or produce a single case similar to the initial Smollett case. So while the prosecutor's office was giving the idea to the public, you know what, there's multiple cases similar to this, we're kind of applying an even-handed standard of treatment, may seem lenient to you, but in fact, and this reminds me again a little bit of my own case where the government was like, oh yeah, it's very normal for people to do what Dinesh has done, you know, no previous convictions, a first-time offense, small amount of money, no corruption involved or even alleged. Yeah, you know, 2 years in prison, pretty normal. Flat-out lie. There's no case in the history of the United States where someone got... So the same kind of lying is going on here. They also claim that, listen, the $10,000 fine we imposed on Jussie, they go, this was the maximum allowed by law. This is all we could do. And Dan Webb goes, that's a flat out lie. That's simply not true. You just made that up. There's no reason you couldn't have gone to trial. And if you convicted Jussie, you could have demanded he pay back the full cost that the Chicago Police Department incurred in the investigation, because essentially he was forcing an investigation that didn't even need to happen. He was himself the victim, in this case, was the perpetrator. So the Chicago Police Department said, we've spent at least, and this is a very small number compared to what the true, we have actually put out in straight out cash, $130,000. So this could easily have been billed to Jussie Smollett. The point again being that this notion that we could only have charged him $10,000 is a complete lie. So the conclusion of this report is that you've got a corrupt Kim Foxx and a corrupt office, because she wasn't the only one doing this wheeling dealing. There are a number of people under her who are acting, you may say, under her malign influence. I guess this is similar to the FBI, which is you corrupt all the people at the top and then they start corrupting all the people way below them, making it seem like they're merely carrying out orders. But the orders are unethical, they're unlawful, they're not suggested in the law or in the guidelines. And fortunately, Dan Webb now has a report which a judge has ordered to be released. It makes fascinating reading. I just read it earlier this morning, and it shows that we're dealing in these democratic cities, not just at the criminal level, but also at the prosecutorial level, with some mighty dirty individuals.